Well, the fantastic thing about straw bales is that it's on one side a material which can be used for insulation because it has a very good lambda value of 0.052 or 0.08 depending on how you put the bale. It's better when you put it on edge. But you get a good insulation value which is maybe 30% worse than polystyrene. That's the first huge advantage. The second is that it's maybe the only insulation, except foam glass maybe, that is also load-bearing. You don't have other materials which can insulate and carry a load.
Since all my professional career, I'm concentrated on natural building materials. We did a lot of research projects and we did a lot of experimental structures. And I found out that the building material earth is the most available normally. It has a very less footprint. You only have to dig it out to transport it, but it's free normally, or you pay a little bit. And you hardly need any energy for the process to produce it. And we are using normally green bricks, unburned bricks, or adobes, handmade adobes in foreign other countries. So no energy, no CO2 production, no spoiling the environment. And for me it's very interesting, the indoor climate. In my house where all the walls and also the domes are from earth material, I have a relative humidity of 50% nearly all over the year.
I really started to like architecture when I found out about possibility to use natural materials for the building, because before it didn't for me make much sense to build houses which are not healthy and which are very expensive. So now I feel very happy to find this direction in the architecture.
I was always fascinated of domes, the space, and so some 18 years ago I designed my own house where all the main rooms are covered by domes. So and then I started to study more the possibilities of domes. We built two kindergartens with domes and I built some meditation halls, one in India, one in Brazil, one in Germany. And I felt always that people had a special feeling in these rooms. And so I wanted to do more with it. And my aim was to build a strawbale dome.
As I travel a lot visiting conferences connected to this subject, strawbale building, I met a few years ago Mr. Gernot Minke, and we became friends. And Mr. Minke mentioned that he had this project of strawbale dome he would like to build. So I had idea that why don't he build it here in Slovakia, because we have a plot, so it wouldn't be problem. And I know that we didn't have problem to get permission for strawbale buildings in our area. So, and he said, well, maybe that's a good idea.
Well, the whole process of the building starts, of course, with the foundations. We did some design decisions at that point. The formal plan was to maybe do the walls in porous concrete bricks. And I wanted to do it in wood. I also introduced a floor done by foam glass. So the whole process started in the design part, where we changed some materials. As for the walls, building the walls was fairly simple because we had the formwork and we could put the straw bales on the formwork until we put in the last piece. So maybe the difficulties with walls are that every line or every level of straw bales has to have a different angle so that it really fits. And this was then calculated by computer. In fact, the dome is much simpler in that case. We had a rotational guide in the middle, which has the center a little bit eccentric and a little bit lower down than the ring beam. This was important because the curvature of the dome was adapted to the optimal curvature. To cut these straw bales, which is the most important part of the building process, in fact, we had a machine built, custom built for this use, which Gernot brought.
Who could do two cuts on both sides in a special angle, which we decided first. The computer told us which angle we have to do. You have to control that it touches here when it comes out. Don't make it like this.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So the first machine we had was for a project in Tamera in Portugal. We built a vertical machine with only one saw.
Well, we used clay more or less everywhere. Maybe I should start that we used clay also for the floor, because on the foam glass, usually we do a concrete slab and build the house on that. That's the normal way you do it. Here we thought, well, why not try to make a packed, dense clay floor, which we were compressing.
Imagine a straw that goes, that holds by itself.
Wow! No way!
But yes, it does go by itself. Thanks to Uncle Gernot. Imagine all what you can do with straw. And that's just the beginning. Oh, you will see, everybody will know what's wrong. When they'll see a straw, they'll go. Everybody will want one in his garden.
Take this out a little bit. Yeah.